I wanted to write a cynical poem about my first experience at the West Edmonton Mall. I mean, I really did, and I tried pretty hard. I started by twisting up the sickest prompt I could think of, remixing a memorial to those that we say died for our freedom with a memorial to those I saw at the mall all around me that day, killing themselves in the name of the free market. I wrote, "In West Edmonton, where the poppies smoked and sold in hawk shops row on row." And then I stopped. I felt sad. Pathetic even. Because as I wrote those words, I sat eating bangers and mash and drinking Guinness in Sherlock Holmes' pub on what is known as Bourbon Street, not too far from an Earl's, a Tony Roma's, a Hooters, and two enormous food courts. An environment breeding indigestion and cynicism, to be sure, and so I wanted to write words so bitter that the beast's belly would grow upset and I would find myself vomited back out into the blue skies and sunshine outside that indoor city, although I have to accept that I went knowingly to the carnival of gluttony and that my cynical distance from the people in the place was as falsely manufactured as the hopes and dreams being sold there. As unhealthy as the greased pies I spent my entire day consuming, and about as thoughtless as the consumerism in which I became submerged. You see, I went with two friends, and the entire bus ride over, we spent preempting our feelings of disgust, voicing our sense of distance from shopping and malls and the people who inhabit them. My one friend said, "You know, the people watching is pretty good, but it kind of makes me feel like I'm at the zoo," to which I added, "You know, what really upsets me is how disconnected I feel from the people there." As I pictured them, with their lips firmly sealed to the plastic teats of commerce and sucking hard. But then, in retrospect, I realized that what really upset me was how connected I felt. Especially as excuses for spending began forming on my lips and my fingers began scratching at my wallet, because I have to accept I can't live without coffee or meat and potatoes or beer or more coffee or a seal show or an indoor water park or an ice rink or glow-in-the-dark mini golf or bowling! Especially when it's happy hour and the games and the beer come in baskets and the fries are bottomless. As we left that day, penniless and unsatisfied, I looked wistfully over my shoulder at the roller coaster park, and then I composed the following poem for my friends. Yeah!